The very last thing that I want to talk about here is the idea of practical, very commonly referred to as clinical significance, versus statistical significance. In short, statistical significance, all that means is that you have a small p-value, smaller than alpha. So you could reject. That's what it means to have statistical significance. Practical significance, on the other hand, in a nutshell, means the difference observed is meaningful. You can have clinical significance in observed values that lack statistical significance, so you can't infer it to the population. Likewise, you could have statistical significance, small p-value, but the observed values do not have any practical application or use. Here's a quick example. Suppose we're looking at the difference in GPA of, say, male versus female athletes at a particular college or in a particular state. Or let's just limit to a particular college, that'd be a little bit easier. So let's just say that we take a look and we find that the average, say X bar for the women, this is GPA average, is 3.47. And X bar for the men is 3.42. Now, numerically, the women is clearly greater than the men. So if the sample size is big enough, then the p-value will be smaller than alpha. I don't care what you set alpha at. You can always get a big enough sample size that no matter how small alpha is, you can get a statistical difference. So this would be statistical significance. Oops. Fix that real quick. However, what I suggest is that there is no clinical significance. There's no practical significance. Who really cares if the women have 3.47 and the men have 3.42? Is a difference here in the hundredths place meaningful? I mean, seriously, what good would it do for you? Now, on the other hand, let's just change this for a moment. Let's just pretend for a moment that the men say 2.42. That's a little bit more than a full grade point average. That's significant. This is a mid C and this is a mid B. That would be important. So if the p-value is smaller, then it'd be worthwhile to go back and say why? What's the difference? Did the women or the coaches of the women teams recruit scholar athletes? They looked at their GPAs first before they brought them on. They wanted good, solid students, but perhaps the coaches for the male teams didn't. Or additional research could show that the GPAs, their entering GPAs, were the same, and these may be after year one. Well, what's the difference now if they came in with statistically the same GPAs? Why are they different now? Perhaps the women are doing, or women coaches are doing something different during study hall. Maybe they're doing something different with tutoring. This would be worth investigating, trying to figure out why, so that we can improve the male scores. This would be what's there to improve. There's no really difference here. Numerically, yeah, but practically, there's no practical significance, practical use in knowing that they're different. Again, with this as a two, there is a good reason to figure out why they're different if there is, in fact, statistical significance. If there's not statistical significance here, then the sample size is clearly way too small. So we can't conclude that the women is really greater than the men. In general, this is kind of important. In general, we think in terms of the bigger N, the better. And that's true. This is really true in estimation. The bigger sample size we have, assuming the sample is representative of the population, the better the estimate we're going to get for the population parameter. This is not necessarily true in hypothesis testing. Because in hypothesis testing, if you get a big enough N, you can always show statistical significance. That's why this idea of statistical and practical significance must be kept in the back of your head. Just because you have big enough N and show there's a difference between these two groups, it's now time to look at what the difference is. If numerically the difference is not useful, then the statistical significance is irrelevant.